Hello folks, welcome to Sherwood Park Toyota, located at 31 Automall Road in Sherwood Park, Alberta, Canada. Today I'm going to be showing you this 2016 Ford Explorer Limited. Now the most notable features on this Limited is its navigation system. You also have your heated steering wheel and your parking sensors. Now I'm going to go through a couple more features on the inside and outside of the vehicle, just to get you better familiar with this 2016 Ford Explorer Limited. Let's get started. Now, a couple of the exterior features that you will see on this Limited is its daytime running lights. And then if we take a closer look just at your front bumper here, you are going to see your parking sensors, and over on the side, you have your 20-inch aluminum alloy wheels. Now, you also have your foldable mirrors, as well as if we take a look on the inside of the mirror here, you have your blind spot monitoring indicator. Now with your blind spot monitoring indicator, it'll actually light up, just letting you know that there's another vehicle right beside you. You also have your integrated signal lamps. Up top, you have the window visor guards on all four sets of windows with your roof rack. And the color we're going to be taking a look at today is red. Now to start off with, we're going to be taking a look at your front dash as well as your front seats, just so you have a much better idea of how much space there is. Now you have your black leather interior seat surfaces with your power driver seat with lumbar support. You have your power pedal adjustment as well as your power tilt telescopic steering wheel, light controls, power lift gate release. On the inside of your driver's side door, you have your seat memory controls for your driver 1 and 2 with your power locks, mirror controls with your power folding mirror button, and your window controls. Now a couple of the controls you'll see here on the steering wheel include your scroll function, cruise control setting, and then you also have your scroll function with your Bluetooth connectivity, volume control, as well as your voice recognition. Now the other nice thing is you do have the push button start, so all you have to do is put your foot on the brake, hit the push button, and it will start up for you automatically. Now taking a look at the multi-informational display, you're going to see a couple of different options on here. So with the multi-informational display, you have the gas indicator. You also have your digital clock and being able to go through your navigation. Now, one of the nice things with this is that you can actually scroll through a couple of the different menus on here. So using the controls just on your left-hand side, you'll be able to see your tire pressure monitoring. You can also take a look at your speedometer, as well as a couple of other additional features. Now using the controls on your right hand side, you can actually scroll through and take a look at your phone, entertainment, and your navigation system. So depending on what your needs are for, you can have just your navigation on, just if you want to take a look at that. And taking a look now at the center dash as well as the touch panel display, you're going to see a couple of different options on here. So with your home screen mode, you have four different options for yourself with your phone, entertainment, climate control, and your navigation. Then you also have your home screen button with your settings menu in here. And as you can see, you have your dual zone climate control settings up there as well with your heated and cooled front seat controls, along with the heated steering wheel. Now, taking a look just down below here, you are going to see your temperature control settings as well as your volume control. And if you take a look up top here, you have your parking sensors on and off. And I'll actually show you what this button does just in a minute here. But as you can see, you also have the heated and cooled front seat controls for your driver and passenger down below here as well. And then you also have some storage space down below. Then this is also where you will find your USB and auxiliary input mounted to an automatic transmission. And if you take a look just down below there, you have your terrain select down there. And if we take a look up top here, you have your tilt and slide for your power moonroof, as well as for the sunshade visor here. So if you want to open it up, then you can do so, just to let a little bit of light in. And then just on your driver's side here, you are going to see your integrated garage door opener controls as well. Now for the backup camera, I'm just going to throw this into reverse just so you can see what it looks like. So as you can see there, you have that nice back end view, just so that when you're parking in a parking lot, you can actually line everything up. Now you also have the guiding lines on here as well, so when you turn the steering wheel, the lines will actually move depending on which way you turn the steering wheel. Now if we take a look now, when we put this into drive and then hit this button that's located just in your bottom left hand corner here, as you can see, you have that nice front view of the vehicle. So not only do you have the backup camera, you also have the front camera as well. So those of you who park in a parkade, it comes in handy, especially when you need to know exactly how much room there is between you and the wall. And if you press it once more here, as you can see, you have a couple of different views just located here, just so that you can see if there's any obstructions in your way just before you head out for your day. Finally, we'll be taking a look at your rear cargo area as well as your tailgate, now located on your rear bumper. You're going to see your parking sensors just located right across. On the back of the tailgate, you'll find the backup camera just underneath your Explorer emblem, and then down below you'll find your rear hatch release. All you have to do is push on the button once and it will open up for you automatically. Now I'm just going to close in on the rear cargo space just so you have a much better idea of how much room there is. So as you can see in your second row, you have captain seats, but not only that, they're actually heated captain seats as well. So not only does your front passenger get to enjoy a heated seat, but so does your second row passengers as well. Then they also get to enjoy the view just with the moonroof in the back there, just in case they want to enjoy the scenery just when they're driving at night, just counting the stars. Now the nice thing with this third row is it's actually a power folding third row, so depending on what your needs are for, you can have both of them down or one of them up. It's a 50-50 split. So as you can see here, you have a couple of different options for yourself. So if you want to have them stowed for both of them, then you can just adjust the controls accordingly. Now if you want to actually fold up the seat, just hit the button, and then as you can see, it'll actually fold the seat up for you, making things much easier for you. And then when you're all finished up, all you have to do is just hit stow, and it will stow itself back into the floor for you. Now, the other thing I like with this limited Explorer is it does offer you that power tailgate. So once you're all finished up, all you have to do is push on the button once and it will close for you automatically, making things much easier for you when you have your hands full of grocery bags or the kids' sports bags. Thank you so much, folks, for watching this video today. If you have any questions on this 2016 Ford Explorer Limited, please visit us. We're located at 31 Automall Road in Sherwood Park, Alberta, Canada. The phone number is 780-410-2455, or please visit our website at sbtoyota.com to get us by email. Once again, folks, thank you so much for watching this video today. If you have any comments or any additional questions, please leave them in the comment section located down below. Other than that, make sure you have a great day, and I hope to see you next time.